الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين محمد وآله أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تلك الدار نجعلها للذين لا يريدون علوا في الأرض ولا فسادا والعاقبة للمتقين صدق الله العلي العظيم وقد قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر إلى آخره أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. My most respected elders, beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, young friends or very early Christian members to our Jamaat. May the peace, mercy and the blessings of Almighty Allah descend upon us all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has encouraged His servants with utmost humility. And while He has encouraged that we remain humble, He has also prohibited pride and arrogance. He has mentioned about that ultimate abode of the hereafter, the Jannah, the paradise. We have always been hearing about, we have been reading about since the days of Maktab. Heaven, Jannah, paradise. We read so much about its description in the Quran and the Hadith. It opens the appetite to hear more and more. The manner in which Allah has described paradise, it is such that no one, no heart, no mind would ever conceive of. It's indeed a very special place. We sometimes wonder and read who are really the special servants who will inherit the Jannah. Allah has mentioned in this verse, Tilka darul akhirah, that abode of the hereafter. Naj'aluha, we specially assign unto those la yuriduna uluwan fil ard, those who do not seek for altitude, for heights. They do not seek to have ranks and positions to be recognized as those of high status. And they are the ones who do not ever indulge in confusion, in making gavata and corruption, mischief on man. While one could say, Jannah is a place for those who read fight and salah. Yes, we know that through Allah's mercy and through His kindness, that a person who performs fight and salah with sin sincerity, inshallah, will attain Jannah. It has not been mentioned that the person who pays zakah will go into Jannah. But we hope Allah will admit the payers of zakah, the givers of charity, high place in Jannah. Nor was it mentioned those who go for Hajj 3 to 5 times will attain a place in Jannah. It's a hope, and we hope that Allah will admit. But what is mentioned here, Allah says it, that abode of the hereafter, Naj'aluha, we specially assign unto those La yuriduna, who do not ever look for recognition. They are not the ones who crave to take the spotlights. They do not want to be the top stars here in the world. Wherever they go, they must be on top. It's about me, I. Had it not been for me, they are the ones who are not like that. Uluwan, the word Uluwan means altitude. From Uluwan you get that superlative degree, Allah. A term that every worshipper says in prostration. Allah. And that is when the worshipper goes down in the lowest posture, having his forehead rubbing on the musalla. There is when he says, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Glorified be my Lord, who is Allah. He is the worshipper, he goes down to the lowest to recognize Allah is the highest. Glorified be my Lord, who has altitude, the one who is the highest. Higher than Allah, there is none. And any servant who chooses to go after Uluwan, altitude and heights, always want fame and recognition. Allah looks at him very carefully. He orders the angels, how the close watch on him. SubhanAllah. Look how Islam, the Quran, encourages us no matter who we are, what we are. It encourages us to strive to be humble. To be humble, look at the very postures in the best form of worship, Salam. The postures are such that it compels a worshipper to inculcate into his life throughout that humility. It makes us humble. Look at the method adopted by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for eating. No matter who we are, what we are, he used to sit on the ground and said, Akuluka layakul abd. I will eat like a slave would eat. Wala akulu mutaki'a. And he said, I will never eat while reclining. How many Muslims are guilty of this? You sit in front of the television and you rev up on your recliner and you eat like a pig. I don't eat like that. But I eat like a slave would eat. A Muslim is eaten. A morsel of food falls onto the aida, the duster and the cloth. That's the food falls onto there. Pick it up. If it has any speck of dust, remove it. And then let him eat it. وَلَا يَدَعْهُ شَيْطَانِ. Do not leave it for shaitan. Such are the actions when one does them. It inculcates, it makes us inculcate humility. A proud person cannot pick up a morsel of food that falls and eat it. Leave that. He takes another one. Yes. A humble person, you're given a glass of sharbat. Drink. Bismillah, precepts, you drink until the glass is empty. It's not about glorified rainbow Lord or the little thing. That's not Muslim. That brings pride into the heart. To eat and believe. Do whatever you put in your glass, you have a plate, you eat it. Clean the plate that was shown to us by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't leave a thing that you are leaving it for manners. What do people will think? Forget the people. It is what Islam teaches. It has great sense of wisdom for us. It makes us become humble when a believer eats and he cleans the plate. He wipes the plate with his finger and Yalakul Isra. He licks the fingers. The Prophet upon peace has shown us. The plate means dua. Oh my Lord, you cleanse and purify him his sins. Just as he has cleansed me. Are we forgetting that? We are studying about following the Yahudi and Nasara. We leave something a little bit for manners. You are leaving that for Shaitan. He will eat that and give power, topic, and give him a tongue. Such are the actions that will force humility in our lives. Let me assure you, mashallah, we are told in Quran where the best you have when you are going to the house of Allah. Today, mashallah, is Eid. We look forward, it's the highlight of the week. Dress nicely, whatever Allah has blessed you with. But along with that, when you are dressed and you are leaving your home, then the Prophet upon peace has shown us the method of khuruj, of coming out. One comes out and says, Allahumma, inni kharajtu, I have come out, makhraj al-abdil dalil. I have come out like a very humble and low servant. I have come out like a slave, and you say it and you hear it. You internalize that. You leave your home talking to yourself, I am nothing but a slave. And when you come like a slave, anybody will throw their hands to you. Assalamu alaikum. You don't pull away. You give your hands to anybody. Anyone will say assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam. With an open heart. You are willing to forgive. You are willing to forget. You are willing to make amends. My brother and sister, that's the coming out of the person that you belong. La yadkhulu al-jannah, says the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. A person will not enter Jannah. Man kana fi qalbihi, who has in his heart, mithqal dharrah min hibar, an atom's worth of pride. Yes, mithqal dharrah, coming here with his faith, the seed of a mustard. A pencil mark on a copybook page, so fine. That amount of pride present in the heart of a person, no matter how many amal salihah, no matter how great the deeds are, hasanat, such a person will not enter Jannah. But Allah will not do injustice. You have come, you have your passport, you have your actions, but what is deep in you have? You have that pride. Allah will arrange that you be humbled on that day. And Allah, no one knows what method it will take for humility and for that pride to vanish from the heart. It can be great. So let us do away with the pride right here in the world. It is not something we can learn just by hearing a name or teaching one. It is something we have to make effort. We have to talk to ourselves. At one time the Prophet upon him, he said, O people, is that you? Have shame. Have shame. Sahaba Zikiram and Kerala, this is the Prophet of Allah, we are modest, we throw it on ourselves, we have shame. He said, not that I am talking about. I am telling you, each one of you, remember yourself in the grave, where your body is covered with worms, eaten your meat, eaten your flesh. You imagine yourself in that halat, in that condition. When you can place yourself in that position and believe it, whether you accept it, whether I and you accept it, the fact remains no getting away. Even in Qasidas we learn that we are just a being of hungry words. Such lovely reminders we are given from little things like Qasida. We are nothing but a being for hungry words. We get great reminders. He said, you on a daily basis picture yourself in the grave and your body covered with the hungry words. Where and how could pride remain in the heart of such a person who can't remember such things? Think about it. It makes us recognize that we are nothing. I am nobody. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he went up on that blessed, stupendous journey. He was the man of the moment, so we speak. He was the top star. It was not an holy angel, Jibreel alayhi salam. Yes, he met all the various beings, the prophets in the different skies, but it was not about them. He met them. Allah wanted him to meet them for reasons mentioned. But look, when he was given his gift, the salah, and he was returning to the world, he met with Moses, who confronted him, what your Lord gave you, my Lord gave me such and such, you go back. Tell your Lord, your people will not handle 50 times Salah. The Prophet departed because realized that there was a place beyond Sidratul Muntaha where only he alone could have gone, not even the escorting angel. He knew how much recognized and honored he was. But when he was told to go back, he didn't tell Angel Jibreel, come, let's go. It was his humility. He looked at him with the eyes as if he was asking his opinion. That is humility. He looked at him with the eyes as if he was doing the same. That was when the escorting angel said, if you wish, come, I will go with you. That was humility. When we turned to Baitul Maqaddas, it was time for the pray, the dawn prayer. He was the man of the moment. He lagged behind, thinking that others were more, you know, appropriate to lead the salah. That was when the angel Jibreel alayhi salam ushered him. No, anta imam. Muhammad, you, no one else, you are the imam. What is that if it is not humility? Come on, if you are the pish imam of the mosque, of course, that's your duty. You don't lag behind. You have to go on because you are the imam. There it is. There was no appointed imam, but it was all about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did push himself up. Angel, usher, you, no one else, you are the imam. He showed us humility in every form. He said, man tawadu alillah, rafa'ahu Allah. Always remember this. Whoever humbles himself for the sake of Allah, there are times when you are not wrong. Maybe you are not right also. Okay? You are not wrong. But why are you going to humble? Why am I going to still forget the past? Be it your husband, be it your wife, your brother, sister. Why are you going to still forget the sake of Allah? Open your arms. Doing it for Allah. Man tawadu alillah, rafa'ahu Allah. Whoever humbles for Allah, Allah will take him up to the heights that no one else will carry him. Sometimes people remain not speaking for years. What prevents anyone from saying, I'm sorry, please forgive me? What else but pride? What else but pride? We must take note of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. And He wants us all to enjoy a very special comfort in the paradise. Again, there will be no proud people. No proud people. For anyone with an iota of pride in the heart will not be able to enter into the Jannah. And this Kabir was said, and said by the Prophet of Allah, a man, a person, yuhibbu wa yakuna thawbuhu hasana. Normally, a person who has ambition, he likes his clothes to be neat, well pressed, and looking nice. Wa na'aluhu hasana. And he likes his shoe to be shining and clean. That might be a proud person. The Rasul of Allah would be said, in the Lord and Jameel. No, Allah Himself is gracious, He's elegant. Yuhibbu Jamal, and He loves elegance. Yes. Allah Himself is ambitious. He loves ambition. Not that I am talking about. What I am talking about is rejecting the truth and encroaching upon the rights of others. Always trying to downplay other people. You must be very careful about that. Wherever you go, at a picnic, wherever you go, with friends, with the family, you must always be the one looked upon. Because of that, be careful. Learn to give chances to other people. Learn to be humble only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in Jannah and in Jahannam, grand debate. Not only in Parliament there is grand debate. The hell spoke first and boasted to Jannah. Fiya al-Jabbaru. Hell said to Jannah, in me, I have the Jabbaru. I have the haughty people. The tyrant people. Now, I want to make it very clear, Jabbar is not wealthy and rich people. Jabbar is haughty people. Come on, you know it. In the time of the Prophet upon him, he's just as today, there were Muslims who were very wealthy. But you see, you know, it's amazing. There are many wealthy people who are the humblest of the humble. And that's remarkable. So when you talk about Jabbar, it's not wealthy as translated by many people. Hell said, in me, I have the haughty ones, the tyrant people. For Qalatul Jannah, Jannah in response said, Fiya, no about us, I have the weaker ones, the humble servants of Allah. Allah, He made a nice coming to go to them. He said, Inna Fiya Jannah, Rahmati, O Jannah, you are my mercy. And I will descend my mercy and whosoever I want. And O hell, you are my Lord, you are my punishment, and I will punish you whosoever I want. But hear it, وَلِكِ لَيْكُمَا أَلَيَّ مِلْكُمَا. It is binding upon me, O hell, O heaven, that I will fill both of you. In other words, Allah will fill hell with the arrogant, the proud people, while He will choose to fill the paradise with the very humble servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very authentic the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us therefore strive to make every possible effort to do away with pride. Find ways to expel, to eradicate pride in any. It's not about one telling himself, you see, we are a humble person. That's not the way. You don't tell yourself, look, I am humble, when in fact your qualities suggest otherwise. The way you speak to people, the very method of your walking should display to you. The Quran shows us, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرْحًا. Do not walk on earth merrily and boastfully. The walking of a Muslim is different from the walking of other creatures. Animals walk. Yes. All human beings walk. And when you see a Muslim is walking, he is mindful that one day he will leave the surface of the earth and he will be put below. You don't stamp and trample and walk in an arrogant manner. वो वेरी वॉकिंग शुड स्नेप तो आजो ह्यूमिलिटी वी हैव टू परफेक्ट दैट ट्रायल एंड मेक श्योर दैट द अर्नड एंड द रिसेम्बल द वॉकिंग ऑफ रसूल अल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम वला तुसाहिल खल्ला कादिनस इज द ऑफिस एंड नोबडी owns the office as much as you are the owner. But still, Allah is saying to the believers, وَلَا تُسْعِرْ حَدَّقَ لِنَاسِ Do not cough to a Facebook people. Allah will then say, right, thinking you are superior to others. Oh. It pays off sometimes. Give it a smile. You won't lose anything. Give a smile. لَا تَحْتَبِرَنَّ مَعْرُوفًا Says Nabi Akram alayhi salam, do not underestimate any good deed, even though you look at your brother, my brothers, you look at your brother, you meet them, you watch him coming with such confidence that is so evident. In fact, you know it is not fitted. I said not fitted for Israeli lie, I tell you, not halal. So you look at your brother in such a way that when he sees you, he is left to wonder. What have I done him for? He is left to wonder what he has done to you. You didn't lift a finger yet. You didn't open your mouth yet. You only glanced him one glance. Even that lieth ill. Look how the Quran teaches us and protects us. May Allah make us among his very humble servants. Humility is the way. When you are very humble, it becomes so easy to abide laws whenever you do. And recently we spoke about, you know, Islam teaches us all to become good law-abiding citizens. You see nowadays, mashallah, we always try to obey the law and do it throughout your lives and teach it to your children and friends. We are driving at 80 kilometers on the highway. Yes, 80 kilometers, you are safe. Be it that you are on the right or the left lane, and you are able to recognize the arrogant ones, waving and waving your hands, you are abiding the law, you are within your rights to drive 80, no more than 80. There are some more of you, because you are obeying the law, they want to rule you over 80. You have the right, where you will go. Those in the left are slow. They will be. We obey. When you are humble, it becomes easy to obey rules and regulations. Be it at school, the rules and regulations of the mosque, and we do have, find out, there are. Wherever you are, there must be rules and regulations. It's the humility to learn, no matter who you are. Always know that Allah is the one who has appointed a group of people who will check others. There must be those in authority. It's not about who you are, who you think you are, an iron source. Humility pays off. Man tawadda billahi rafa'ahu Allah. Whoever humbles himself for Allah, Allah will give him up. Allahumma ja'alna min ibadika al-mutawadda. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafa'ana wa iyyaka bil-amali wa bil-'ilm.